So I'm gonna pick this letter zero. Oh, Euro cylinder that Leon sent me. Said that it needs a shim or pinning shoe or something. Which makes me wonder if it's a challenge lock or not, but Azeo is an Italian brand, as far as I know. Yeah, I'm gonna pick it in the clockwise direction. Put some Euro cylinder tension on there. And then pick. Just pick the pins. Just trying to pick 3, 4, and 5, and then 2, and touch 1, and then touch 3 there, deeper false set at the moment. Quite a deep false set. And then 3. 4, 5, don't know, could have set it there, don't really know for certain. Right. Okay, so let's have a look at what's inside. Okay, now since there's no clip on the back, I don't have to worry about any clip. But what I will do is just maybe put it like that, and hopefully nothing bad happens. And then the pinning shoe in there, 4 Euro cylinders, just like that. Then grab the slug follower like there, push that out, or not. Alright, now I think I've got it right. Well, tell you one thing. It's definitely a challenge lock, unless Azeos have serrations in them. As you can see there, that one there is smooth though. Which would explain why it's so difficult to pick in the other direction. But an open is an open. Definitely a challenge lock. Had a wafer fall out there. Right. Okay. Alright. So is a serrated pin in 1, or serrated key pin that is. There, and then a slight serration on 2, and that little wafer there, and then you have kind of a spooled key pin. Don't think it's a pin in pin now. No, that's a spool, and you have this T-pinned, I think. Yeah, that's a T-pin, key pin, and a, I think that's just a standard pin. Alright, So, and then up in the top of the lock we've got, what do we have? Okay. Well, we have something going on in there. Something strange, anyway. Careful. Hang on. I know what to do. Let's see here. Alright, so hopefully, fingers crossed, this is gonna work. Not trying to be easy, anyway. I can see why we need a shim, all right. Give me a second.